Simon & Schuster Audio presents Galactic Hot Dogs, Cosmoe's Wiener Getaway by Max Brallier. Read by Vincent Martella.
Chapter 1. Mega Dog in the Bun. This is going to be the best hot dog we've ever made. When dudes eat this, they're going to be like, "Hot dog! That hot dog was delicious."
Two more dashes of Jupiter Jolt sauce,
my buddy Humphrey says as he piles on the ingredients. I'm Cosmoe, the little human from Earth with the big funky hair. I own a flying hot dog truck with my best buddy Humphrey. He's a big alien-looking guy. Why am I here, in space? Well, that's a story for another time. Why am I here today? We're on Spaceport Funktown, cooking up a mega dog for the intergalactic food truck cook-off. Dude, this dog is the size of a Jeep, I exclaim.
What's a Jeep?
Humphrey asks. Ugh, sometimes I forget I'm the only one around here from planet Earth. Never mind. Come on, let's get this thing to the cook-off. The Intergalactic Food Truck Cook-Off is a major event. Flying food trucks come from all across the galaxy to serve up crazy treats for the Queen. Our truck is the Neon Wiener, and it's docked close to the market where the contest goes down. Sweet scents from 1,000 different exotic dishes waft through the air.
This could be our ticket to the big time. If we win this cook-off, we'll be bona fide,
Humphrey says. Evil Queen Dagger judges the cook-off. She's royalty and she's mega rich, so she has like 37 million soldiers and spies working for her. And if she doesn't like your food, she just might disintegrate you. You think Evil Queen Dagger will like the mega dog? I ask Humphrey. Humphrey can tell I'm nervous. He's observant like that.
Of course she'll like it,
he says.
No one's going to have anything nearly as good as this. I doubt there will be any competition at all.
With the mega dog in tow, we make it to the entrance of the cook-off. Inside, there are hundreds of chef-type people running around and setting up amazing-looking dishes in front of their food trucks. Aw, smudge!
Dude, don't stress it,
Humphrey says.
As long as we have the mega dog, we can't lose. And the mega dog isn't going anywhere, right?
Wrong. Just then, that hooded fiend nabbed our mega dog, I shout. Humphrey doesn't say anything. He just makes his old rumbling noise. Ever since Humphrey retired from the pirate life, he's been a pretty mellow, chilled out guy. But when he gets really mad, he starts making this rumbling noise and, whoo boy, watch out. You don't want to mess with him. I mean, listen to these stats. Species, Bronchal. Home planet, Bronchelia. Age, 127 Bronchal years, 34 standard years. Height, 7 foot 2 inches. Weight, 1.1 tons. Humphrey, I say, trying to remain cool and calm. Just relax. Don't get all crazy on me. This is a job for Goober! Let's meet my buddy Goober. Fact. Goober is the rubbery, elastic blob that is forever wrapped around my wrist. Goober is symbiotic and lives off my adrenaline. That means he can't leave my side or he'll die. But it's worth it, because Goober is frappin' rad and can turn into all sorts of awesome junk, like Goober the Hammer. Goober the annoying pal who never, ever leaves. Goober the fart dampener. Goober the Fist! Okay, back to the action. I'm darting through the market trying to find the thief. I catch a glimpse of the megadog, bobbing above the crowd. There! The crowd clears and goofy aliens step to the side. Perfect! I flex my wrist, letting Goober know it's about to be action time. Goober, go! I shout, and then, smack! I yank on lasso Goober, and superb lasso move! Bring the jerk thief stumbling back. And that's when I discover the thief is... Evil Princess Dagger! Oh, man. I just goober-grabbed the heir to the intergalactic throne of evil! My mind races. I'm thinking on how bad this is going to get when I hear a voice shout,
"The tiny hot dog-selling creature attacked Princess Dagger!"
Hang on, folks. This is about to get uglier than a butt convention. "Whoa, whoa, whoa!" I shout. "Little misunderstanding here. I didn't attack anyone, and I'm not a tiny hot dog-selling creature. I am Cosmoe the Earth Boy!" Humphrey grabs me by the shoulder.
"We need to split."
I yank the mega dog out of the thief's hands. Not without this. And then it's off to the races. "Excuse me, watch out! Coming through!" We come out of the crowd, and I see our ship in the distance. I fish inside my pocket, grab the neon wiener keys, and hit the unlock door button. Behind us, energy cannons are blasting away. Lucky for me, Humphrey is both heavily armored and heavily protected. Humphrey holds up the angry mob while I try to squeeze the mega dog through the door.
"Get inside!" Humphrey barks.
"Not without the mega dog!"
"Little buddy, I am going to kill you when we get out of here. Forget about the hot dog!"
Humphrey pleads. "No! We spent a lot of time cooking up this winning wiener!" I push and push and push. Ugh! I'm totally scuffing up the mega dog. Finally, it squeezes through. Inside the cockpit, I'm flipping switches and pressing buttons and spinning knobs like crazy. Humphrey makes it inside, and about 5 space seconds later, the engines are heating up and the ship is undocking. Another 7 seconds, and the neon wiener is rocketing into interstellar space, leaving behind Princess Dagger and the angry Port Funktown mob. But now, Big Humps wants to talk. He places one of his massive paws on my shoulder.
"Cosmo, heart-to-heart time. You can't just be whipping goober around and lassoing evil princesses. It's bad for business."
I hang my head. "I'm sorry, Humps, but she was stealing the mega dog." Humps scratches his chin.
"Good point, but still."
We're interrupted by a silky smooth voice saying, "Excuse me, gentlemen." My throat goes, gulp. "It's evil Princess Dagger. And she is aboard our ship." "What the butt? What are you doing here?" "Stealing your ship, silly. I'm an evil princess, you know." I start stuttering. No. "You can't be here. Your evil mom is gonna think we kidnapped you. She'll kill us." Princess Dagger is about to respond when, bleep, bleep, bleep.
"Brace for impact," our pet robot Fred says.
"Smudge! It's the Royal Navy," I exclaim. "They're trying to shoot us out of space." The princess has a sly smile on her face. "Duh, they think you kidnapped me." I shoot her a supreme mean look, and then I hang on tight. Fred warns,
"Impact imminent."
Butts! Chapter 2, Princesses Are a Pain. I'm scared, not going to lie, big time nervous. These two royal rockets are closing in fast. I'm at the cockpit, hands on the wheel, squeezing it so tightly, my knuckles are fleshy white. I'm pretty definitely positive I'm about to get blown up. Suddenly, Princess Dagger yells out, "Hey, weird hair, watch out!" and lunges at the brakes. Slam! The rockets miss, like, just barely. The explosion is massively, monstrously King Kong-sized and white chocolate hot. We all tumble back onto our butts. Princess Dagger sits up, scratches her head, and whispers, "Wow, that was heart-nukingly crazy." Humphrey chuckles as he gets to his feet and says,
"The princess is good, Cosmo. I'll give her that. She saved our butts."
What the fuzz? I'm supposed to be the hero, doing all the saving and everything.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.